Hi everyone, this is Brandon here and welcome to my next episode, Day 13 of my Let's Clash series. So currently we're going to take a look at one of the defense that happened to me. So this guy was using Barbarian archers to attack my base. So just to start things off, this guy was doing it very nicely, deploying in a whole entire base, surrounding the whole entire base in fact. And then eventually when the Barbarians, they broke through the wall, the archers just from behind just shoot over the wall. So having level 5 Barbarians and Archers, they are very strong, that's why I'm trying to get them as soon as possible. So yeah, after the defense, I went ahead and do an attack of my own, finding this Tower 8 with over 300,000 gold available for me to loot. So I was focusing on the gold mines because the gold storages, they were pretty protected, unable for me to go all the way to take the gold storages, especially with such a low level Barbarians and Archers. And also in fact, there were already more than half of the gold inside the gold mine. So just going ahead to take out the gold mines, I got 190,000 gold from it itself already. So just ending the raid right now with 23%, losing the attack definitely. And then eventually I found another base with over 270,000 gold. So in the end, going ahead to attack it and just focusing on the gold mines because that's the only thing that I'm actually looking for. So just stole 200,000 gold from the gold mine with one more gold mine available for me to steal from. So my troops, they are breaking through, going all the way into the gold mine itself. Eventually, I accidentally dropped a lightning spell and then my clan castle came out. So that was a mistake on my part. So sometimes we do make mistakes definitely because first of all, I'm playing on a smaller screen. So I'm not really used to playing on my iPad. Of course, even so, I do make mistakes, but farming at such a low trophy range is not too worry. Losing and also making mistakes isn't too much of a problem, but if it's in a higher trophy range, of course it's going to cost me like a huge amount of trophies. So now let's go ahead and watch another defense replay that occurred to me after me going offline, after looting all those loot. And then eventually this attacker was using some giants and some barbarians and archers also without any healers, and my clan castle came out with the balloons, and the balloons, they took out the giants very quickly. However, he was really smart to use the archers to try to take out my balloons. So the archers, they are level 6 archers, so level 6, they are very strong to do a lot of damage. So taking out all my balloons really, and then eventually just continue to attack my base. I found that this guy was pretty smart to not have deployed all his giants and then eventually all get taken up by the balloons. So he saved some giants to actually continue the raid, and then eventually deploying some level 5 wall breakers to break through my ping walls. So just continuing the raid, he was doing it really nicely, executing the attack perfectly. However, I think that he could have brought some healers, maybe substituting some of the giants with like one or two healers. I would think that that would be a more optimum strategy to use, especially if you are planning to use like a mass giant strategy. I think it's better to use some healers. Even if you don't have any healers, I would say bringing some heal spells would be better. So that's something that I would prefer to use if I'm actually using a healer giant strategy. However, I don't plan to use a healer giant strategy because my best and optimum manner way of farming would be barbarians and archers, and also using some minions, so which is barbarian minions and archers, which is BAM. And then in fact, just going back to my base, one of the upgrades, the elixir storage, has just completed. So going ahead to remove one of the trunk, the tree trunk. So in fact, it was very good to give me 5 gems, which I totally liked. So the highest amount of gems you can receive from one obstacle is 6 gems, other than the gem box, which you can actually receive 25. So going ahead to upgrade the walls with the remaining amount of gold I have, in fact it was at the cap already. And then upgrading all the walls to the max possible level that I could for my Town Hall 6. So getting all the walls to max level, that was really nice. And then just going ahead to do another upgrade, upgrading my barracks because I don't need to farm for gold at hardcore right now. And yeah, done with the walls, completed the walls for this Town Hall 6. Eventually, when I get to Town Hall 7, there'll be more walls to upgrade and also a newer level to upgrade. One piece of wall to level 7 wall would cost 200,000 gold instead of currently, which is only 75,000 gold. So I'm just planning my way, stocking up gold using my same old method of stocking them up on the national flags itself. And then eventually, once I reach to Town Hall 7, I'll have more gold to accommodate to my whole entire base. In fact, maybe I could even upgrade one or two of the walls before I proceed on with the upgrades. Because the first thing that I'd like to upgrade when I go into Town Hall 7, I'll try to upgrade would be my Town Hall. Trying to get it to Town Hall 8. If I remember correctly, it costs 2 million gold to upgrade to Town Hall 8. So once I reach to Town Hall 7, I'll just go ahead to upgrade to Town Hall 8. So it takes like 8 days to upgrade to Town Hall 8. So within that 8 days, I should be able to max my walls to level 7 dark purple crystal walls, which total up will requires 41 million, taken into consideration that 125 of the walls which currently I have right now, which will cost 200,000 gold each, and also the 50 new walls would cost even more. So just totaling them up, I total it up to 41 million. So for those of you who are wondering how do I get all this kind of information of cost of the walls, or in fact what kind of upgrade times I'm able to calculate out this and that, I actually got the information all from clashofclanswiki.com. So for those of you who wants to know the website, I'll put a link in the description below so that you guys can go ahead and take a look and check out all the various upgrade level, upgrade times, and also how long and how much it costs to upgrade to a certain level of a particular building itself. So like for example, if you are planning to plan for the next town hall level and you want to plan to upgrade a certain building, say for example an Inferno Tower, then you will be able to check out how much it costs, how long it takes to upgrade this and that from the website itself. I find that the website is very helpful and it has helped me all the way ever since I started playing Clash. So that's it. I will hope you guys go ahead and take a look at the website. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my episode, and Clash on.